Saturday, sunshine and footy. It's a dream gig for 20-year-old Joseph Green. He's a referee and he's been doing it for years.
I started refereeing touch when I was about 12 and sort of progressed to national scene there. And then from that, one of my mates who I'd met through touch invited me to come along to league. And then from there, it sort of taken me on a bit of a journey.
His mate Vigo is also a ref.
Played a few years of Fox and then too many injuries. I wanted to stay involved in the game. The next best way was becoming a referee and trying that challenge. So that's pretty much how I got into it.
Unfortunately, this isn't a story about the many joys of being a referee.
Do people swear at you guys?
All the time.
Yeah, that's normal.
All the time. That's the stuff probably can't mention.
Yeah. We probably won't mention that on TV, but like there's often they're swearing.
This is a story about a long-standing trend in Aotearoa, sideline abuse from spectators.
How common is it though? Is it a regular occurrence or is it every now and then?
Yeah, like you hear the odd comment pretty much every week. You know, you sort of hear those real detailed comments like sort of the F-bombs and all the swearing under the sun. That's sort of the ones that, you know, can happen from time to time and can affect a lot of us quite personally, really.
I stepped away from the game. A couple of my good mates didn't come back because of the referee abuse stuff, so I just wanted to take a break, hey? And I started hearing stuff, and I've never heard stuff before until this year, and then it just, man, it was pretty loud, eh?
A video recently uploaded to social media showed a ref breaking down after being abused from the sidelines. That referee was Joey.
Joey, you probably didn't even know the video camera was recording. Can you just tell us what happened that day?
When you've got like 20, 30 people just pretty much abusing you, saying everything under the sun, you know, it's a pretty daunting thing to face. You know, you get a couple of comments from players that you can hear quite distinctly. I don't think anyone should really have to put up with that. It's just, it's unacceptable behaviour. And, you know, sort of just wanted to, if I'm being honest, I wanted to leave the game after that.
I've always said when I first came into the whole NRL academy here that Joey would be like the next person to represent New Zealand on the NRL scale. And I still firmly believe that. And it really did annoy me. And I just felt like we needed to make a point that it isn't okay. I was actually going to come back the week that happened and do a couple of weeks. But once it happened, I was like, nah, things need to change. People need to realise. And I think by me taking the stance I did and Joey taking a few weeks off, it kind of made a few people realise. And if that's going to help change a few people, then sweet, that's a win.
That whole week after the incident happened, like, life just got real dark. Yeah. But yeah, like, it took a massive toll on me. Like, it's sort of just a reoccurring thing every weekend now. Just go to a game and, oh, you know, what if someone's going to abuse me again today, to the point where, you know, like the video shows, I break down on the sideline.
The abuse isn't exclusive to Tāmaki Makaurau or any one sport. It's everywhere.
After a game, someone just walked through the car park and just was yelling, you know, like typical stuff like, oh, you're a shit ref. But then it turned quite sexist, like, oh, women belong in the kitchen. And that just really pissed me off.
I think for me, even like, if you had a bad game and you had received some negative feedback from others on the sideline or just through the grapevine, it's the aftermath, like, you know, what would you encounter in the community after that? Some people actually have to have a legitimate reason why you made the decision in that moment, and they, like, hold on to that memory. Never mind about the 78 minutes that you refereed really well, that 2 minutes that happened, they'll hold on to forever.
Yeah, like, the general public would be quite shocked with some of the stories that, or just the things that people have witnessed and have had happen to them.
Jackson has been officiating rugby union and touch for years. He loves it. It's taken him around the world and he's put in a lot of time to make games.
You travel quite a bit sometimes to get to games. Tell me how long.
The longest club I travel in terms of club rugby is 3 hours.
So that's a big sacrifice though.
Definitely a big sacrifice on individually and on my whānau, so.
A sacrifice not appreciated by some. Jackson has seen sideline abuse for over 20 years. He's been the target of racist abuse, been picked on for his appearance, and has recently received a death threat.
It was things like, if he comes back to our marae, we're going to run him over. And,
yeah.
He better not come near us, we're going to kill him. I actually had to sit down with my whānau, my wife, and just to reassess, is it worth continuing? You know, I'm a volunteer at the end of the day. I'm my parents. You know, I'd be lying if I said it didn't mess with my mental health. I was actually nervous to go back to that club, to be honest.
So they can have long-lasting effects, so?
Definitely.
Yeah.
Yep. That'll be one of the times that I say that I actually was truly going to hang up the boots. However, if I can make, you know, the world a better place for referees and for the spectators and players by bringing this behaviour to light, I'm more than happy to advocate for it.
When you are at the elite level, the abuse can come from anywhere. Henry Perenara knows that more than anyone. His every call magnified and critiqued by the masses.
Kia ora, Henry. Thanks for chatting with me today. Social media, how has that changed the game for refs at your level?
I think the hardest thing now these days is social media is so strong.
Yeah.
So I made the decision to stay off it because at the end of the day, as a referee, like especially at my level, there's not very many nice things, if any, that are said to you.
Referees get it right majority of the time. Sometimes you guys get it wrong. How do you deal with that when everyone does the big pile on?
I guess the thing that people have got to understand is, like, at the level I was currently at, we had security guards. If you remember the infamous Bulldog South Sydney game, bottles got thrown at the boys.
Yeah.
You have a look at how many security guards were around them. Regardless, abuse at any level is not acceptable. I kind of come to become accustomed to it because every decision I made was magnified because it's on TV. You know, you've got tens of thousands of people watching the game, and every single one of those people that are watching it through the colours of their team. So regardless of any decision that I make, people are going to be upset one way or another. I kind of quickly become accustomed to that and, you know, developed a very thick skin. But in saying that, it's definitely on the rise, the abuse, and especially at the grassroots level. And that's something that, you know, in my opinion, it's not acceptable, especially the ones where people are hurt. And we could be losing referees. The amount of young referees that walk away because of the abuse is just through the roof. And you know, if we can find ways to stop that, then we need to try and find those ways.
Joey is back out on the field doing what he loves. There's still a bit of chatter from the sidelines, but people are becoming more aware. Joey is now focused on reaching that NRL dream.
What's it like being back out on the field?
In the first week I was back, I actually heard one of the spectators who was quite intoxicated up on the veranda at the club was, "Oh, you're a crybaby ref." And I was like, "Oh," like, you know, I was with a comment like that, I was able to laugh it off. But yeah, like, there's maybe half of the players around now sort of have that extra little respect for us, realising that we are human, we're going to make mistakes. And there's certain clubs out there who are, you know, trying their best to change the culture. And like Virgo and I appreciate what they're doing for our game at the moment to help referees feel respected.
Probably just want to say a big, big hat off to all the referees out there in all the different sports. You know, what they do for the game is next to none, probably the most important thing. Putting your hand up to referees, not easy. And it takes a different sort of person to step into that space. So keep doing what you're doing, things will change, and hopefully this is a stepping stone in making the culture a little bit better.
Just my message would be to understand that we're human. We definitely make mistakes. We have families. You know, behind the whistle, behind the referee uniform, there's actually a person there who has feelings, who deals with mental health, who has kids that are on the sideline listening to the kōrero that's been said. And, you know, to actually understand that, but, you know, we don't get it right. But we're out there to make sure the game grows.
Big shout out to all the refs. Keep doing the mahi. Good luck, Joey, with that NRL dream, and looking forward to seeing you back on the field there, Vigo. That's our show for tonight. Pō marae.